A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th October, on the front page you have Supreme Court reserves Ayodhya verdict after 40-day marathon hearing. So appeals had challenged the three-way partition of the disputed site by the Allahabad High Court. So this ruling of the Allahabad High Court was appealed in Supreme Court, and Supreme Court has had a constitutional bench set up which has had a 40-day hearing, continuously a marathon hearing, and now finally the judgment has been reserved. So appeals had been filed, cross appeals had been filed by both Hindus and Muslims. Both were not happy with the three-way partition of the disputed 2.77 acres Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid site. As such, the three-way partition was among Ram Lalla, Nimroi Akhara and Sunni Waqf. So this was the ruling of the Allahabad High Court in September 2010. So on this appeal, now ruling of the Supreme Court would come now in 2019, as it's expected. Then this is produce all orders on Jammu and Kashmir curbs, court tells government. So Supreme Court has scheduled case for hearing on Jammu and Kashmir on October 25, and has asked the Solicitor General Tushar Mehta to produce the orders passed by authorities on restrictions in Jammu and Kashmir as well as Section 144 proceedings. So this was judgment direction by three-judge bench led by Justice N.V. Ramanna. So CJI is not part of this three-judge bench, and the Solicitor General responded saying that these orders cannot be made public, and we'll give it to the court for the perusal and consideration only. On page 8 you have, our main aim is to save Telangana RTC, says staff. So this is regarding ongoing strike by employees of Telangana Road Transport Corporation. It is going on for 12 days with no immediate thaw between government and the staff inside. So here you can see the employees are seeking arms at the bus depot. So the chief minister has also taken a defiant stand, and he has said that they did not report for work and they are dismissed. So though they had been given a warning to come back to work, they did not, and now they stand dismissed. Two have even committed suicide. So the situation is dire here. On page 9 you have center to issue negative list to streaming sites. So Information and Broadcasting Ministry is likely to issue a negative list of don'ts for video streaming services or over-the-top platforms like Netflix and Hotstar. So the ministry has also nudged the platforms to come up with a self-regulatory body on the lines of News Broadcasting Standards Authority. So there needs to be guiding principles for the content on these platforms. Then this is indigenous breeds record marginal rise. So foreign cattle has grown 32% according to cattle census, while indigenous breed has seen a marginal rise. You can see it's less than 1% higher than population earlier. The last census was conducted in 2012. So this is the 20th livestock census. So the native milch cows there, and the crossbreed cattle, like various varieties such as Jersey or Holstein, which have much higher milk yields, their population has increased over 32%. So this is over the last 7 years. And here you can see there is this scheme, Rashtriya Gokul Mission, which is also detailed out. This was a scheme launched by BJP government in 2014, aimed to promote indigenous desi breeds. However, total population of such cattle, male and female together, milk producing or not, actually dropped 6%. While exotic and crossbreed cattle saw overall growth of almost 27% to 5 crore animals. So milch cattle grew 32%, while overall they've grown 27%. But indigenous population of cattle has dropped. On editorial page, the first editorial is refusing to recuse. So this is regarding Justice Arun Mishra. So there is demand that he should recuse. Recuse means step aside from the bench so that, you know, another judge is appointed and there can be unbiased decision. So recusal of judges, actually they can take the decision as such, individual decision too, and when the case is, when matter is compelling and it requires his recusal. So there's a demand being made, but he refuses to recuse. So it's his own decision actually. So what has happened is there is this 2013 land acquisition law in which compensation issues arise that when compensation should be paid. So Supreme Court ruling came in 2014 which settled the matter, but then in 2018 a Supreme Court bench which had Arun Mishra, Justice Arun Mishra in it, it overruled this 2014 judgment. So you can see 2014 judgment was overruled by another 3 judge bench. 3 judge bench ruling was overruled by another 3 judge bench. So it was unusual because every bench is bound by the precedent set by another bench of the same size. So if a bench differs with the ruling of earlier bench, it has to refer the matter to a larger bench. But that did not take place. So anyway, it was against the norms of the judiciary too. And this 2018 overruling created furor and resulted in protests. And now, on this overruling, a bench is being set up in which Justice Arun Mishra is again part. Because he was part of the 2018 ruling, the demand is that he should step aside, but he refuses to. So that's the whole matter. And this is agents of change. So it says there is evidence of overall benefits that accrue from investing in women's education. So we had seen regarding this survey, the Comprehensive National Nutrition Survey, in which studies showed that if mother is educated, then health of child would be better. So overall benefits would accrue. So that's what this editorial also argues, that there should be investment in women's education. And the lead article, taking national data seriously. So it says India must not trade away its national data rights at the RCEP negotiations, that is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So in that e-commerce chapter, we had seen how India resisted, negating its data localization norms. So that is covered here. And this is the operative word must be bilateralism. So it is about India-US relations. So India and US, it says, can work closely in reshaping the global order. So we have a potential in trade as such too, and in resolving global issues, including issues in Afghanistan, and the Pacific region, etc. On page 12, you have, we'll throw out every intruder before 2024. So this is Amit Shah, who says, Union Home Minister, who says that the Narendra Modi government would single out every intruder in the country and throw them out before 2020. So this was what he said at an election rally in Haryana. Then below you have, government officials violate RTI Act with impunity, says Chief Information Commissioner. So this is Chief Information Commissioner Sudhir Bhargava, who has accused government officials of violating RTI Act with impunity, taking advantage of court orders that they cannot be penalized except in cases of malafide intent. So this is what has been stated. So RTI Act has been diluted, its implementation has been diluted, there is pendency of cases. So there are huge concerns here. While earlier we have seen Union Home Minister Amit Shah saying that there is no need for RTI in the country now because Modi government is completely transparent. On page 13 you have, Z mooted trilateral ties with India-Pakistan. So days after the second informal summit took place between India-China, Foreign Minister and State Councillor Wang Li has said that Chinese President Xi Jinping had shared with Prime Minister Narendra Modi his vision for trilateral cooperation among Beijing, New Delhi and Islamabad, that is India, Pakistan and China. And this is Kartarpur corridor work going on round the clock. So India is racing to meet the deadline of October 31. And this is Kovind to attend Akihito's coronation. So this is regarding President Ramnath Kovind's visit to Japan. He'll be in Tokyo on October 21 after a 4-day visit to Philippines. Britain's Prince Charles, Chinese Vice President and leaders of several Asian countries will be attending the enthronement ceremony of Japan's new Emperor Akihito on October 22. On international page you have, US House passes Hong Kong Rights Act. So this act requires US President to sanction those responsible for rights abuses in city. China has slammed this bill. And this is China leases an entire Pacific island for 75 years. So, island of Tulagi, which served as South Pacific headquarters for Britain and then Japan during Second World War. So, this has now been leased to, it's part of Solomon Islands. It's about to move into Chinese hands. So, this Solomon Islands, Tulagi Island as such has been leased by China. State company will has secured its development rights for 75 years. So, it was Solomon Islands which had ties with Chinese Taipei or Taiwan. So, it cut ties with it and joined Beijing. And now, a few days after this, now you can see we have this Tulagi Island deal finalized between Solomon Island and China. Then on business page again, there is news regarding public sector banks. Present finance minister putting the blame on former leaders, Manmohan Singh, the prime minister himself, and Raghuram Rajan, former RBI governor. So she says that the worst phase of public sector banks was then. And this is Geo alleges illegal extraction again regarding call termination charges. But then these two articles, you can skip. Then on last page you have bring on the punch. Manju Rani's journey has just begun. So this is regarding Manju Rani, who has been India's only silver medalist from recent boxing world championship. And below you have peanut paste not a solution for severe malnutrition. So clean drinking water and sanitation is also as important as food is what has been highlighted. So this is a new study published. And it also talks of here you can see article on how India is ranked 102 out of 117 in Global Hunger Index 2019. So it's also behind Pakistan, Bangladesh and Nepal. So the report has been prepared jointly by Irish Aid Agency, Concern Worldwide and German organization Welt Hunger Hilfe, and it has termed level of hunger in India serious. In 2018, India was ranked 103 out of 119 countries. It was in 2000 when India's rank was 83 out of 113 countries, but it has fallen. And the indicators, four indicators which are used under Global Hunger Index are undernourishment, child wasting, then child stunting, and child mortality. So, what is child wasting, child stunting, how it is calculated is also detailed. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.